How's it going, everyone, and welcome back. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to get all this juicy pure quartz. And we're going to set up a nice little farm base to get an infinite amount. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell. Okay, so this is the first location, and in my opinion, the best area because it has the most nodes that I've come across. And this is the second area, so it's not as good as the first one, but it still has a decent amount of nodes. And if you haven't already, check out my previous videos, especially the infinite coal video, because that shows you all the best miners that you can get early in Power World. So whether you're a new player or not, eventually you're going to need a lot of pure quartz to make circuit boards. Now, circuit boards are unlocked at level 35 and they make the best stuff in this game. So your late game production lines, your late game furnaces, your late game kitchens. Now it costs 4 pure quartz to make and some polymer, but you will burn through pure quartz pretty quick, especially if you're setting up multiple bases with a lot of these items in. So for example, here it takes 5 for the electric kitchen. And then if we look at the sphere assembly 2, it takes 10, and it takes, I think it's 10 for the other ones as well. And also you need them for things like the jet dragon saddle, a lot of late game saddles as well. And you need 10 for the electric furnace. So it starts adding up pretty quickly, but you definitely need it. And if you're going for defenses in your base, like the missile launcher, you need a lot of them as well. So it's a resource you're going to need in abundance. And I'm going to show you how to get loads of it. So before starting our little adventure, you want to make sure that you've got pickaxe and helmet unlocked and the flower bed. So you can get the pickaxe and helmet at level 30 and the flower bed is at level 24. So these two items will increase your mining speed and your gathering speed, making a more efficient base. Look at all that juicy, juicy quartz. Now the good thing about this location, which is the first one I showed you, is that it's in quite a neutral zone. It's in a very dangerous biome. It's the late game snow biome, but this area in particular, it has no wild pals around, or no dangerous ones anyway, so no pals going to come into your base and start trouble. Oh, hello. It's a shiny. That's a shiny Mamarest. See, they don't attack you unless you provoke them, so you might get a couple of these roaming, and that's about it. Oh, I've got no legendary spheres, but if I leave, he's going to despawn. Ugh, what am I going to do? I think if we can wear him down, let's just see if the Megasphere can capture him. There's an annoying bug, by the way, when you're on Jet Dragon, where if you go into the aerial missile, it stays in that camera mode. You have to dismount and remount to get out of that camera zoom. It's really annoying. Right, let's get back on him. Let's try and wear this guy down. Ugh, why can't I mount you? What's going on? Right, we'll try again. There we go. Right, we just need to get him super low and then we will try and capture him. I don't think it's going to have it, though, with the Megasphere. This is so annoying. I can't believe I went out of my base without any legendary spheres. What an idiot. Oh, right. Let's wear him down. Oh, it's still 0%. Oh, no. I'm not going to be able to capture him. Oh, no. And I've just killed him by accident. Whoops. Oh, there's a chest there. Do not tell me that there's good spheres in there. Of course there is. Why wouldn't there be? How typical. Oh, why didn't I see that chest sooner? I'm such an idiot. Oh, no. Oh, well, back to the task at hand. So there's about 8 or 9 nodes that spawn here, so there's quite a lot. So let's establish a base. Let's get a power box set up. Now, I'm not going to do anything fancy here with the base building. I'm just going to build a nice little simple base because it's going to be purely used for a good couple of days worth of farming. And then I'm going to destroy the base. And if I need more, I'll come back and do it again. But we need to just check the perimeter. Oh, that's a little bit out. So we need to move the power box in a tad. Just in case the gatherers like decide not to go beyond that. I'm pretty sure they do, but just in case, we'll just build it a bit closer. But yeah, this base is not going to be a decent looking base. And ideally, if you're going to farm pure quartz, what I would do is set up a base at both the first and second location that I showed you. And then you can just get tons a day. The yield has been pretty decent. It's anywhere up to about 1,000 a day. Now, I don't know if they respawn every day because sometimes they can take a day in between to respawn, but the yield is really, really good. Sometimes I like to just stop and look around because the biomes and the map in this game are absolutely beautiful. It's such a phenomenal game. I'm really surprised of how Power World turned out, and I'm glad because I needed a new arc. That's it, boys. Let's get building. Let's get this base set up. My trusty little Sparkets. They're not the fastest builders, but they're my little army and I love them. So these are all the materials I've got so far, so we'll take them out this storage box so we know exactly what we're going to get when we check back in a couple of days' time. So Pure Quartz is a late game node, and you're going to need panels with level 3 mining and above, and if you're going to harvest it yourself, you need a refined metal pickaxe. Now, I explained in my previous video the best miners to get for mining, especially early on, but if you want a quick answer, Digtoise. He's got level 3 mining, you can get him at level 18, I think he starts at around, so you can get him pretty early into the game. But for this base, I'm going to be using Menesting, Astagon, Beacons, and Sparkets, you know, just for the gathering. Now, normally for gathering, I'd use Anubis, but I'm using all of my Anubises in my main base. They're busy at the moment, so this will have to do. But they will do the job lovely jubbly. But like I said, if you need a high-level miner early game, Digtoise. So I was just getting some food for my mining bases, and I just remembered to show you a neat little tip. So if you've got a refrigerator and an ice pal cooling it, take it out of the inventory and put it back in, and it resets the timer. It's a cool little trick, isn't it? So that way you can keep your food from wasting. You know, I love the building in this game. I like the orange, the way it just grows up and then expands and then the building's done. It's so cool. But yeah, this is turning out to be an efficient base. So my beacons are currently busy, but I'm going to get them back soon. And like I said, I can't use Anubis because they are busy as well. But yeah, this is going to be an efficient little base. And like I said, if you want even more quartz, set up 2 bases, so in both locations, and you'll get tons. Speaking of the other location, here we are. Now there's only 6 nodes here. Normally there's about 7, so it's not as much as the first location. However, make sure you've got some cold resistant gear, and then you'll be able to farm this really early into the game, so long as you've got the pals and the pickaxe to do so. So what we're going to do is we're going to mine it ourselves and see what the yield is on average per day at this location. Let's go. So we got 720, not too bad at all. So we'll take this back to HQ at Fort Curtis. Normally there's about 7 nodes there, but this is still a pretty decent yield. So I'd say on average, you're going to get between 700 to 900 there. So yeah, pretty decent, especially the fact that you can get there pretty early. But we're going to go Betty Buys now. It's a brand new day. Good morning, everyone. Right, out the way, I need to fast travel. Oh, I hate it when the big pals get in the way. Move. Move, you chunky boy. Move. I'm trying to fast travel. So it's been about 3 in-game days now since I've visited this base, and we're going to see how much loot we got going on there. Right, so they're still busy at work. Let's check the box. Let's see what they've gathered so far. Ah, pretty decent. So 2,000, and they're mining again. So let's give them a little hand. So I've got my beacons here, so they're gathering pretty quick now. Let's give them a little hand and get it all in the box and see what the total number is for 3 in-game days. Now let's put it in there before I get weighed down, because I ain't going to be able to grappling hook with all these pals in the way. Right, let's get this last bit of iron, shall we? Oh, I forgot to repair my pickaxe. What a nana. Okay, this is going to take a little bit. Oh, it's not going to take a bit of time at all, actually. They're mining pretty quick. Come on, boys, give us a hand. Let's get it done. Ugh, this is a drag. Why are you walking away? Help me mine. Silly pals, what are you doing? Oh, this is so long when the weapon's damaged. Ugh, there we go. Right, let's pick up all these rogue scraps and let's have a look. That is pretty decent. So 2,000, so it looks like it's spawning every other day, which is fine. So at this location, about 1,000 a day. I am happy with that yield though. Let's go back to HQ, Fort Curtis, and let's get it all in the box and see what we got. Let's try and grappling hook over. Out of the way, Anubis. Thank you. Oh, he's a big boy. It's not letting me grapple over because they keep getting in the way. Get out the way. Oh, there we go. Right, let's put these in. That is looking like a decent yield. Let me just put this soul away in the soul box, and then we'll have a proper look. Yeah, that's pretty decent. So I would say on average, you're looking at between 700 to 900 at base location 2 and upwards of 1,000 at base location 1. So if you've got both bases going, you're looking at about 2,000 a day or every other day. So really good. Good locations to use. Hopefully you found some value in this video and found it helpful. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and share this video as it massively helps out and I really do appreciate it. And also hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. And you're also welcome to join my Discord server. We've got quite a growing community of Power World players on there now, so it's got quite a knowledge base going on. It's really cool. But anyways, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.